Hello everybody, and welcome to the second part of these Warpy tutorials, in which I'm going to demo how to register two images. So I will use these two demo images that you can download if you click on the link given in the video description. As a first step, I need to define a QuPath project, which will contain all the images that I need to register. To create a new project, I can simply create a new folder that I will name Demo Registration. And I will simply drag and drop this empty folder into QuPath and click Yes. Within this project, I need to add the images I need to register. And I can do this either by clicking Add Images or by drag and dropping these two files into the QuPath window. Here there is one specificity linked to the Warpy workflow. It is compulsory to set as an image provider this bioformats builder. If your images are not compatible with bioformats, then you need to convert your images. And a way to do this conversion is also given in Warpy documentation that you can find in the video description. So let's click Import. And now I can quickly show you what these images are made of. So the first image is a hematoxylin DAB image. So I'm setting the type in QuPath. And basically all nuclei are stained with hematoxylin and the dividing cells are stained with DAB. The second image is a fluorescent image, which was acquired exactly on the same sample, but a different area. So I can set this image as a fluorescent one, and I can increase a bit the contrast so you can see the two channels. The first channel, channel one, is a DAPI stain, which is staining all the nuclei, and the second channel is an EDU stain, which is staining specifically the dividing cells. To sum up, both fluorescent EDU and DAB are targeting the same cells. Before we move on to Fiji, there is one thing that you really need to check with your images. It's that the pixel size is set correctly. So for that, you can click on the second tab in QuPath and check that pixel width in pixel height is set correctly. What I mean by correctly is that this value should not be in pixels, but it should be with a physical unit, either micrometers, nanometer, millimeter, whatever, but it needs to be a physical unit. If you see a value set in pixel, you can double click and override the pixel value in order to set it to the correct value. And you need to do this before moving on with the Fiji part of the workflow. For now, we are done in QuPath, but we can let the project open and simply minimize the window. Let's move on with the Fiji part of the workflow. So I'm starting Fiji. And I will open my QuPath project by typing QuPath into Fiji's search bar. And here you will find the command open QuPath project. Now I can either click Browse or drag and drop the QuPath project file into this field. Before clicking OK, just make sure that physical units of the dataset is set to millimeter. The QuPath project is opened, but it's not displayed. Instead, it is sorted within a tree view that you can see in this window. And I can double click on the root node and see a node which has the name of my QuPath project. And here between brackets, we see this number 3, which indicates the number of sources that it is made of. So why 3? It's because if I expand this node and expand this important node called QuPath entry entity, then I can recognize that there are two child nodes, The first one is containing my DAB image, and the DAB image is only one source because it's a single RGB image, while the second node contains the fluorescent image in which each channel is a different source. The channel 0 is a DAPI channel, and the channel 1 is a fluorescent EDU channel. Now I will start the Warpy registration wizard. And for that, I can type Warpy. There are two commands, and I'm going to choose the first one, QuPath create Warpy registration. I need to select which source is the fixed source, and I'm going to select the DAB image. And as a moving source, I'm going to select the fluorescent DAPI channel, because it is the one which contains easily recognizable cells. So let's just click OK and move on to the next part of the wizard. And in this tutorial, I'm going to keep the default parameters. If you want more information about these parameters, please check the full documentation. We can finally visualize the fixed image and the moving image. And just to make this a bit more clear, I'm going to select the fluorescent image and increase its contrast by minimizing the maximal displayed value. And at this step of the wizard, I am in the manual rigid registration mode, which goal is to approximately align both images. Here I can see that the DAB image is much larger than the fluorescent image, and also there is a shift here in X, which can be easily fixed. To fix it, I can click Start Manual Rigid Registration, and if I right-click and drag the window, I can actually move the DAB image with regards to the fluorescent image, and when I'm satisfied with the situation, I can click Confirm Transformation. If you make a mistake by, for instance, doing a left click, which will rotate the image, and you want to go back to the initial state, you can just click Cancel Manual Registration, and you're back to the original state. You also have a few buttons which can simplify your life, so you can hide the moving image or hide the reference fixed image. Also, if you rotate, you can click Restore Initial View to go back to your original state. There are some shortcuts that you may want to look in order to be more comfortable in the navigation within Big Data Viewer. For the most important commands, right-click allows you to drag, and using the mouse wheel up and down allows you to zoom in and out. I'm going to perform my rigid registration by clicking again this button, dragging the fixed image somewhere where it looks fine, and click Confirm Transformation. This is now the second step of the registration wizard, in which I need to specify a rectangle that will be used for the automated affine registration. There is a default rectangle which is surrounding completely the fixed image, and I can restrict this to a smaller area by drawing a newer rectangle. If I made a mistake during this part, I can draw multiple times a rectangle and repeat the operation until I am satisfied, finally clicking Confirm Rectangle. The third step of the wizard consists of selecting patches that will be used to perform local registration, aiming at a precise warping of the moving image over the reference image. To define this patch, I can either click manually using the left click and defining a few patches. If I want to correct this location, I can clear all points. I can also automatically add patches on a grid and I can specify the spacing, even allowing some overlaps if I diminish the spacing, or on the contrary, letting some space on this patch. It is also possible to correct or to modify the location of this automatically placed patch by dragging the patch . So let's make a few overlapping landmarks and hit Configure Points to go to the next step. What we've just seen in the log window is the automated part of the workflow, which is now done. I now have the occasion in the last part of the wizard to review and edit the result of the automated registration. For that, Big Warp is being launched. I have three windows. The first window, which you can minimize and forget. The second window, which we will use to review and edit landmarks. And the third window, which contains the landmarks number and location. What I usually do is enlarge the second window, then I get the focus on this window, press F to display the warp fluorescent image. Here there is a minor bug because the fixed image is not displayed, but we can fix this by clicking the DAB image. So maybe I can also expand a bit the card so we see the name, and set the maximal displayed value to 256. We can now see both images together, and I can zoom in to check the quality of the registration. I can use drag and left click to go at other location. I can also hit Ctrl D in order to navigate from one landmark to another. If I am not satisfied with a specific location, then I can either edit the position of a landmark by pressing space, selecting a landmark, and moving it with the mouse left click. I can exit the landmark mode by pressing space again, move to another location, and add a landmark that I'm placing with Ctrl click. There is now a new landmark that I can position a bit better, and I can add like this many landmarks. When you place new landmarks, do not forget to maintain control while you press the left mouse click button. These new landmarks are appearing in the landmark table. If you want to delete one, just left click and press delete. When your review is finished, you can click this button and there is a message specifying that a transform file has been written within the QuPath project. If I am not satisfied with the result of this registration, I can edit the registration I've just made by looking for the command QuPath edit Warpy registration, hitting run, specifying again the same fixed source that I used and the same moving source. And I now have my images editable through the Big Warp interface. The reason why I don't see them again is due to the display range, and I need to press F in order to see both the moving image and the fused image. I can edit again this transformation, then either cancel or save and close if I want to override this new registration to QuPath. And you can continue the tutorial and check the third video about how you can analyze your data in QuPath.